retire.
I'd like to have your attention here for just a minute, sir.
You can see here that you can pass things back and forth. You want to hand him some papers or cigarettes, you put them right in there, you see? I want to caution you. Let me have a damn good look at anything you pass through, okay? Fine. You, sit down.
I am hopeful. It's perfectly clear to everyone on the tribunal that had you not accepted the cabinet appointment, you would never have been indicted.
Did you talk to her today?
Yes. She sends you her love. And I must...
Is she comfortable? Are they in a comfortable place?
I assure you, Frau Speer and the children are most comfortable. And I must tell you, as I've told her, within 48 hours, your sentence will be set. As I say, I'm very hopeful. And she's very hopeful that you'll be given the minimum. 4 years in prison, 5 at the very most.
Dr. Flaxner, give Marguerite all my love. Tell her I consider my life closed. You and I both know they will hang me.
Thank you.
Optimus, Impediates, Impediant, Perfect Case, Impedivi, Impedivisti, Impedivit, Impedivimus, Impedivistus, Impediverunt, Future Perfect, no, Blue Perfect Case, Impediveram, Impediveras, Impediverat, Impediveramus, Impediveratis, Impediverant, Future Perfect, Impediveró, Impediveris, Impediverit, Impediverimus, Impediveritis, Impediverint.
And the subjunctive case, Albert?
Present subjunctive. Impedium, Impedius, Impediat, Impediamus, Impediatus, Impediant.
Kaiser says we must save gasoline, Albert. He says we must save the tires. It's the war.
In here. He hasn't even slept in his bed.
Where on earth do you think he has gone?
Probably gone into the other room to sleep with his brother.
Oh, yes, probably.
Good evening, Albert.
Good evening, Father.
I regard this as a work of art, Albert. I shall cherish it all my life.
Happy birthday, Father.
Thank you, Albert. Do you want to tell me why you choose to sleep on this hardwood floor instead of in your own soft, warm bed? My own father's ideas of honor and living were rooted in very basic, simple truths which he preferred to conceal rather than demonstrate. And consequently, I always had rather more respect for him than I did love. I shouldn't like to think that I'd engendered that same reticence in you. You went to school today, didn't you, Albert?
Yes, Father.
And apart from school, where did you go?
To the railroad station.
I see. And you were there when the trains came through, carrying the soldiers to the cannons at Verneuil. A great war of attrition, Albert, that no one will ever win. There were other trains there today, too, weren't there, Albert? The trains bringing the men back from the trenches. The wounded, the sick, the broken, the blinded ones.
Yes, Father.
And in your heart, Albert, do you dwell on the men of our nation and their sufferings?
Yes, Father.
So, in your own small way, by giving up the softness of your warm bed, you're hoping to share in the privations and sufferings of those brave men?
Yes.
Albert, all my life I shall remember how much I love you at this moment. My son. My dear, dear son. That ridiculous man keeps on repeating statements about life with which I do not agree.
custom of it is for a young man to seek his companions and his future wife in the same circles to which his parents belong.
The custom is an invention that usually becomes a convention, Mother.
Are you being defiant, Albert?
I'm trying to be precise, Mother. This may not be the time, but I must tell you, Mother, Father, that I'm drawn to a plain artisan life.
And the plain artisan girl?
Yes. Her name is Marguerite Weber. We're planning our lives together.
And how far has this planning of yours progressed?
We were married as soon as I complete my university work. Father, I have no desire to disappoint you or Mother, but Marguerite and I are resolved to be married, and the waiting only makes us more resolved.
It's hard to write these things, Father. I'm glad you're here. And I can tell you that falling in love has actually made me more studious. All my marks have improved.
I shall certainly explain that to your mother when I return home. It'll comfort her.
Dear Albert, last night I paid 400,000 marks for my room and 1 million marks for my supper. Milk is 250,000 marks a pint.
Dear Marguerite, I saw Elizabeth Bergner in St. Joan by George Bernard Shaw. Father writes that the inflation is supposed to end by this spring. But there is no projected date for the end of unemployment and poverty.
Dear Albert, in my last letter, I mentioned Frederick Neumann's ideas for social reform. I also mentioned the pan-European ideas of Coudenhove-Kalergi. You have mentioned neither. This is not a chastisement, merely a confirmation of a suspicion that I have long held, namely that you and your whole generation are completely indifferent to our political situation. Always your father.
An angle may be measured with the usual hexagesimal measure of degrees, minutes, and seconds, or in the circular radian measure. Who can divine that radian for me quickly?
A radian is a central angle subtended by an arcual circle equal in length to the radius of a circle, sir.
His name is Tassenaar, Marguerite. He's the most remarkable, most clear-headed man I've ever met. He's very modern, but he's very basic about the simplicity that makes beauty. In my work, I hope to emulate him. Marguerite.
Your mother and father still don't want us to be married.
My mother and father have to understand that you're my life. And you're going to be my wife.
The Dean of the Institute of Technology has informed me that you have passed your examinations and are licensed to practice architecture. Congratulations.
Thank you.
And? What are your immediate plans now?
To be married as quickly as possible.
Neither your mother nor I can reconcile ourselves to this marriage. You will have to do without our blessing. How do you intend to support a wife?
I've accepted a position as assistant to Professor Tassenaar. My bride.
To my groom.
Mm-hmm. about to learn something.
There's a foxtrot.
A what?
Foxtrot.
Makes little sense. No sense.
It's not supposed to. It's from America. Dancing, you see, is like camping out. It brings out the best and the worst in man. Very good.
Thank you.
Takes rhythm.
Well, I'm being rhythmic.
Patience.
There's no man on this earth
who's more patient than myself.
It takes a sense of time.
Patience, rhythm, timing. Ever since I married you, I've been developing my sense of timing.
Wow. Most of all, it takes concentration.
Tell about patience and concentration.
Albert.
Rhythm?
I'm asking for your help.
Tell him how to row a foxtrot.
Oh, come, please.
Do a foxtrot?
Look, he frightens me.
He's the one that's frightened, huh?
What?
That you or I will never speak to him or my mother again. Now, keep that in mind.
Albert.
Father, it's good to see you.
Oh, this is a pleasant surprise. How nice of you to come and meet us.
I just finished 3 days' business in Berlin. To be succinct, I'm not so much meeting you as leaving you. My own train departs for Heidelberg in exactly 3 minutes.
Yes.
You've acquired an adventurous disposition, Albert.
I have acquired a wife who has an adventurous disposition, Father.
Rowing?
Rowing.
Climbing up and down mountains.
Yes, Father, climbing.
I never imagined that there was very much future in activities of that sort. My contention is that a man has only so many heartbeats allotted to him in his lifetime. He's foolhardy to waste any of them. You find the mountains cheerful?
Oh, very much so. More than I can say. I'm afraid I prefer the mountains to the city.
You voiced this preference before you and Albert were married.
I believe it came up in our conversations, Father.
Addressing myself to your wife.
My wife's name is Marguerite.
To Marguerite.
Yes, we discussed it frequently.
Really?
Really.
Well, in that case, you have no right to complain.
I'm not complaining, Father.
You'll have to live with it from now on. Won't he, Marguerite?
Yes, Father.
And in my turn, I must ask you to live with my awkwardness. I'm sure you'll understand that it needed a considerable study of the railroad timetables to manage this accidental 3 minutes together. Your mother is still irreconciled to your marriage, but nevertheless, she specifically asked me to deliver her love and affection to you both.
Get out of here, you fucking Jersey!
I have a business to run, a train to catch.
Goodbye, Paula.
No more Jews! Get to Jews! Down with Jews! No more Jews! Get to Jews! Down with Jews! No more Jews! Get to Come in. You know, the ones in the brown shirts, they want the Nazis to run our country. The other wants the communists to run our country. 3 times now, the same argument in the same street, 1 year. Are you a communist?
No, I'm not.
Nazi?
No.
Well, what are you?
I'm confused.
Confused? Ah, that's good. See, they're not confused, huh? They know exactly what they want. They want to kill each other. Night and day. We're not a nation anymore. We are a monotony of chaos. Stay confused. It's safer. How old are you?
25.
A month?
March?
Date?
19th.
Mathematician?
No.
No?
I intended to study mathematics, but my father persuaded me to study architecture.
And his father before him?
Yes.
People tell you that you're too young to be entrusted with a commission, yes?
They say that very often.
You're very anxious. Very anxious to get on with your work.
Yes.
You'd give anything to obtain a commission.
Yes.
Anything? Even your immortal soul?
Yes. No. I'll keep my immortal soul.
Your career will match your ambition. You will rise rapidly. You will win early fame. You will retire early.
Adolf Hitler is an actor, nothing more and nothing less. Oh, he's effective, impressive, capable. God knows he knows his own business, but what exactly is his business? Acting. Give him a play, but don't give him our government. Let him have a stage, but don't let him have a vote. He belongs in the theaters, not the Reichstag. He has no credentials. However, at the moment, we're a democracy, and we're blessed or cursed with the privilege to think or not to think, to listen or not to listen to Adolf Hitler. God help us, all of us, if he and his Nazis ever get into power.
Do you agree with him?
Of course.
Why?
I understand Herr Hitler is a very restless man who makes a great many gestures.
What he makes is a great deal of sense.
Impertinence doesn't become you, Jurgens. And I hope a year from now we all meet again. Ritter, Grunberg, Wallenstein. And you'll be able to show us all the fine solutions the Nazis have found.
You don't have to wait a year. Hitler will be at the Hasenheit tonight.
What's he campaigning for this time?
For Germany without Jews.
If you sign on the dotted line, they send you a little pin and give you a large number and allow you to pay them 6 marks a month.
students, faculty, professors, and friends. Ten years and 4 months ago, when I was a poor ex-soldier, I spent a great deal of time studying the faces of people. People in crowds, at public places, on the street. I was searching for certain faces. Friendly faces. I like friendly faces. But I must tell you, I have to tell you, that some of those faces in the Reichstag are not very friendly at all.
I have a feeling we're in for a blowy evening. They tell me he overuses the word unshakable.
However, we are not friendly to decadence and negative thinking. We do not smile when we see self-destructiveness and deceit and sellout and compromise. It is my belief, my absolute, unshakable belief, that we
true. Oh, so true. It is my belief that I do use that word much, much too often.
There's a street in Berlin where long lines of Berliners wait in the cold with their wedding rings, with their watches, even their eyeglasses. They wait to sell them to a pawnbroker so they can eat one more day. These are older people, and their dreams of golden years have been shattered by a cruel inflation that has made their life savings worthless. There's no work for these people, with their hearts and their souls and their dignity. There's no work for 5 million of our younger people. I am talking about calamities tonight, because I want to put an end to these calamities. Help me. Give me your trust and your confidence, and I promise you, you will never repent it. Citizens and tell them yes, they will have their golden years, and the specter of inflation will never again be a black shadow over their heads. No more pawnbrokers! Rescue our nation from those treaties that constrain us from solving our economic problems. You and I can see to it that future generations of innocent Germans will not be burdened with reparation payments. Nation from those bankers who would sell away our future. From the communists who and plunder it! From the miners and sellers of our birthrights! From the excessive influence of the Jews in our cultural and economic life! Above everything, my dear friends, I want you to join me, and together, you and you, and you, and you, and you and I, will make this sacred German land forever strong, forever free, forever without want.
Wallenstein.
If you have any questions, Wallenstein, then write them down. Bring them over to district headquarters. I'll see that the Fuhrer gets them.
They say he has the power. Did he hypnotize you?
No. Not at all.
Happy New Year. As of January 13th, 1931, you are party member number 474481. Is that correct?
Yes, it seems to be. Thank you. Thank you very much.
I'm Carl Hampton. Congratulations.
Uh,
Do you have a student named Eric Wallenstein?
Yes, I know him. Why?
In one of your classes?
Yes.
Good student, poor student, what?
Very good student. Why?
He's a Jew.
Oh, I really don't know.
I know. I have to know. The director of the district headquarters, West End, expects me to know.
Who's the director of the district headquarters?
West End?
West End.
Me. Do you own a car?
Yes. Convertible.
Well, this is a doubly important day, and I congratulate you again. It gives me great pleasure to tell you that today you have also been appointed head of the Motorist Association of the National Socialist Party, 1C Sector.
Who appointed me?
I did. Just now. Paying a few marks a month in party dues isn't the National Socialist Party's idea of settling political obligations. Courier duty.
Are we going to have time to get something to eat?
Oh, yes, I think so, sir.
Do I know that man? Is he on the faculty?
No.
Not a student?
No, sir.
Where are they?
I don't know, my Führer.
You don't know? You don't know? You hear that, you people? He doesn't know! You should have stayed in America and played football! Do you have any idea at all what they're doing? Do you have the remotest idea what you're supposed to be doing? In that dumb Harvard University mind of yours? Do you have any idea at all what any of this is all about? I am campaigning! 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 I am campaigning to be elected to the presidency! I am campaigning from one end of this country to the other! To meet and talk to my voters! That is my job! That is my task! Your job, Putsy, is infinitely simpler! All you have to do is arrange to have ground transportation available when I crawl on that damned airplane! So I ask you again, where are they? Where are the couriers? Where are the cars? I want to know!
Ernst Hanstengel.
Speer.
Are you a regular?
Courier. What do you do?
Make him laugh now and then, wash his car, and anything else he tells me when he's in this mood. Bring them around!
Well, what are you waiting for now, stupid? Are we late enough already?
right?
Yes, yes, I'm all right.
I was on the radio.
Go back to sleep.
Do you know what you're doing? You know what you're into.
I certainly do. My eyes are wide open.
Then explain it to me. Tell me, Albert, what's happening? What's happening to all our kind, industrious, cheerful, good people? Tell me, please.
Changes are going to happen. They're happening now. Changes are never simple or easy. But once they're made, all those kind, industrious, cheerful, good people will be better off. Believe me.
I want to be with you. Away from here. I want to be alone with you. I want to talk to you. I want to hold you. I want to be away from all of this violence and shouting, Albert.
The new organization leader for the Berlin East Electoral District has recommended...
My wife.
Oh, has recommended that your husband take charge of rebuilding the new district headquarters. They need him right away.
It's important. It can mean great opportunity.
Congratulations.
The luggage, take it.
One more moment, we would have been out of reach.
Dr. Goebbels has decided to establish a new district headquarters in Berlin that all of us can be proud of. And the new organization leader, Berlin East Electoral District, concurs very emphatically. After all, this is the capital city and...
Just who is the new organization leader?
For the Berlin East Electoral District?
Yes.
Me? Redo the whole place, inside and out.
I have to draw some plans and make a budget. I'm sure the district wants to know how much it's going to cost.
Naturally. And naturally, you're contributing your expertise, Speer. Once we're past this election, and Hitler is the new president of Germany, the party will advance to total political power. And we'll not forget those who have made sacrifices. Until then, everyone contributes what he can.
When you were studying at the Berlin Charlatan Institute, you wrote me a letter. You want to hear what you had to say?
What time is it?
3 o'clock in the morning.
What did I have to say?
My new professor is Heinrich Tessenow. And he is the most remarkable, most clear-headed man I have ever met. His intelligence is frighteningly acute. I mean to try hard to be admitted to his master's school in a year. And after another year, I'm going to try to become his assistant. Does he know what you are going to do?
I have a commission. It's a very old building. It's very elegant. At the moment, it's considerably run down, but it has the proper lines. I hope to retain all of its original elegance, but I also like to introduce certain functional features.
Is this intended to be a residence?
No, it's an office building. Now, the interior is very challenging. This dining room area could become a salon for holding small informal receptions.
May I see the exterior again, please? You're a member of the party, of course. They'd never hand you this unless you were. Did you join before or after leaving the university?
Before.
And after you read Mein Kampf?
I never read it.
You've never read it? Why not? Where else can you find such wonderful stuff like that? I'm sorry. You chose this path. Speer, I've enjoyed working with you. I've always been very fond of you, and I've always hoped that you were fond of me. At one time or another, you and I have discussed everything from Mozart to American Indians. And now, suddenly, we have nothing more to say to each other.
I'm very proud of them. You should be too, Speer. They're all good party members. They don't want to bankrupt the party, so they've agreed to wait for their wages. How many men do you have inside?
12.
They'll have to wait, too. Hitler lost. Hindenburg's been re-elected president. Politics. Probably it would have been too small, anyway.
Wenceslas, look out on the feast of Stephen, when the snow lay round about, deep and crisp and even. Brightly shone the moon that night, though the frost was cruel. When a poor man came in sight, gathering winter fuel.
I always feel that children lend a genuine warmth to the Christmas festivities. Don't you agree?
Oh, yes.
You must eat that up, you know, Marguerite. You must keep up your strength and your health.
I feel very good, Father. I assure you my health is excellent.
Have you been to see the doctor?
Yes.
Well, what did he say?
Just what I've told you, Father, that I'm in good health.
How long have you been married, my dear?
4 years, Father.
Yes, 4 years and 4 months.
Since Christmas.
A month? I can't believe we've been here.
Get
that
out
long.
Of there, you silly no. dog. Come back here.
You don't get it.
Hello, Mother.
Albert!
Is this good news or bad?
I believe Father feels it's bad.
That's not what I'm asking. I just want to know whether this appointment means that Hitler's political career is over.
I don't know, Mother. What makes you think that might be so?
But it's just possible that Hitler has been appointed to be Chancellor of Germany so that Herr von Papen and President Hindenburg can control him. And put him on the sideline for the rest of his life.
Again, Mother, I have to confess, I don't know. You surprise me, Mother. I'd never have predicted today that you and I would discuss politics.
At my age, it's not good to be too predictable. But I must say I would be very disappointed if this rumor were true.
You keep surprising me, Mother.
And for some reason I seem to amuse you. Are you laughing at me?
No. For just a moment there, you sounded very much like a loyal party member.
I am a loyal party member. I've been for a year. But you don't need to mention it to your father. I doubt if he'd understand.
Mother, your secret and deep.
Oh, I would hope so.
Yes?
Speer, come to Berlin. Come now. Things are happening here, important things. You want to be part of them, don't you?
Yes.
I'll expect you at the ministry.
There's plenty of work for the party.
Yes, I know.
Heil Hitler.
Heil Hitler.
Our brand new chancellor has labeled the Reichstag fire the first act of a general communist insurrection. Do you believe that?
There's a clear and present danger to the nation.
I've read his newspapers. Don't quote them. I want to know what you think.
It would seem so.
And what do you think of all the power that's been handed over to him by our poor, befuddled old president?
Extraordinary times call for extraordinary measures.
You're quoting his newspapers again.
You ask me questions. I'm trying to answer them.
And I'm telling you the writing's on the wall. He's out to destroy the upper classes, anyone who's cultured or intellectual. Remember what I say to you today, Albert. I warn you, whatever you build for this man or his officers, you're building to glorify a tyranny.
No, Father, I build because it's my profession. I know nothing about politics or tyrannies. Well, Mother, we seem to be saying goodbye again.
Good luck. Good luck, Albert. What's happening to you two? Or am I being tactless?
No, just saying goodbye. A different goodbye today, not just goodbye to your mother and me, but a goodbye to everything that you once held of important value in your life.
Father, I have to protest. That is simply not so.
Well, you must forgive me if that's the way I feel.
Goodbye, Father.
Is your father right?
My father is emotional.
I'm quoting the minister. The German film industry can only be re-established on a healthy basis if German nationality is remembered in the industry and German nature is portrayed by it. Unquote.
Heil Hitler.
Heil Hitler. At the Kaiserhof Hotel at 8 o'clock Thursday evening. I'll see that he gets the message. Welcome. Garage, please.
Garage.
Have his car brought round at once.
Right away, Herr Hanke.
Heil Hitler. March 21st is the anniversary of the founding of the First Reichstag of the Second Reich.
I'll take it.
Neither do I. What's wrong?
It's addressed to the minister's adjutant.
That's me. Heil Hitler. As well as personal advisor and appointment secretary to the very punctual little doctor who has a very big job these days. He can make you or break you in an instant. If you examine that invoice, I'm certain you'll find that that was ordered 6 weeks ago. Good evening, Dr. Goebbels.
Car?
On its way.
Under no circumstances?
Yes, I will be glad to attend. If I am to speak, let them furnish the subject. You were assistant to Professor Tessenow at the University of Berlin at one time.
Yes, sir.
The academic life has completely lost its attraction, yes?
The academic salary has lost its attraction for me, sir.
Well, Professor Tessenow is a very gifted and able man. Did you not find him so?
Oh, yes, very much so, sir.
Remind me to phone before noon tomorrow, and will you take care of these before you go home tonight? What's that girl's name?
Anne-Marie Kempf, doctor.
Does Fräulein Kempf quite fit in out here in the reception area, Hanke?
She is very efficient here, doctor.
Nevertheless, take it away from the outer office. Let her be efficient elsewhere.
Well, read it.
Every morning, the editors of the seven Berlin daily newspapers and the correspondents for those that are published elsewhere in the Third Reich are told by Dr. Goebbels what news to print and what news to suppress. Dr. Goebbels exercises the same absolute control over all radio broadcasting in the Third Reich, as well as all feature films, newsreels, documentaries, and short subjects.
Yes, well, congratulate him on whoever wrote it. His accuracy.
Is that satisfactory, Speer?
Yes, of course. The reason you're here. He wants this ministry renovated from top to bottom, and that is your contract. Heil Hitler? Good evening, Frau Goebbels. The doctor has asked me to convey his most profound regrets. He'll be unable to dine at home this evening. Yes, of course, but right at this moment, the doctor is attending a rather difficult conference, or I would certainly put you through to him. Yes, well, rest assured that when I have the opportunity, I'll tell him, Frau Goebbels. Yes, yes. And he's also asked me to tell you not to be concerned if he is very late. Yes. Good night. Pick me up in an hour. My dear friend, because I want you to have a very successful and unencumbered career, I want you to tell me about Tessenow.
Professor Tessenow is a very outspoken man.
Friend of yours?
Yes. No.
Which is it?
I still regard him as a friend.
tell your friend that the Gestapo says that he's politically unreliable.
I suppose I should thank you for warning me, but I'm not going to do that. I'm going to remind you where you came from, what you are, what you could be and won't be if you continue with them.
Aspia, I want you to meet my wife. I would hardly undertake any serious work around here without her concurrence.
Hello.
Frau Goebbels.
The doctor mentioned your name and your work many times. He tells me you're a very clever man. Are you?
I'm a very fortunate man, Frau Goebbels.
Yes, he's also quick with his tongue. You have quick ideas, you can sketch quickly. Can you begin quickly?
Immediately, Herr Doctor.
Speer.
First thing I'd have to do is make an estimate so you can
see. It's not what I asked. That is not the question I wanted answered. I want to know if you can begin right away. Can you?
I can start right away. Fräulein Kempf, may I introduce myself? My name...
Yes, I know who you are, Hespier.
Then you possibly know that I have a tremendous amount of work to do around here. I need all the expert help I can get. I'd be very pleased if you would consent to work with me.
I'm afraid that's entirely up to the Reich Minister's appointment secretary.
I've already spoken with Herr Hanke.
Sir, please be informed that as Commissar at the head of this cell and by the authority given to me by my Führer Adolf Hitler, Chancellor of Germany, I call on you to announce the dismissal of all your representatives, rental agents, branch managers of Jewish extraction. I further call on you to be reminded that no more contracts of employment are to be entered into. And so far as such have been effectuated lately by transparent causes, they are to be cancelled immediately. Give them leave of absence immediately. How very smart you look this evening, Fräulein Keller.
I emphasize, it is not religion, but race that is decisive here. Christianized Jews are thus equally affected. In place of these gentlemen, only members of the National Socialist Party are to be employed from here on. Yes, excellent. Excellent. That goes to all six American film exchanges in Berlin. Be sure you address them to the individual managers. I think that's all.
Party rally coming up at Tempelhof. Yes? Of course this is Handke. What area of that administration did you expect to have the final authority? Good. Well then, now you know. Well?
Well, very bad.
Can you do any better?
Of course.
Then do it.
I thought you might like something to eat.
No time.
Intellectualism now is over, and the eruption of the German Revolution is clearing the path for the German way of life once again.
Yeah! It is good that at this midnight hour you are committing the evil spirit of the past to the flames. It is a strong, great, symbolic act. An act which will bear witness before all the world to the fact that from these ashes will arise the phoenix of a new spirit. Yeah! Let us at this moment join together in a vow which under this sky and lit by these flames will be an oath, the Reich, our nation, and our Führer, Adolf Hitler, heil! Heil!
Tonight I discover that if you're very, very blonde and you wear boots, possibly attain the very best this life has to offer. Do you believe that?
Of course not. Tonight was stupid, crazy, wild, out of control.
Was Goebbels out of control too?
No. Very much in control, I'm afraid.
Tonight was his idea of some sort of triumph. I can't explain the man, Marguerite. He's very difficult, very complex, very hard to decipher.
You traded Professor Tessenow for Dr. Goebbels. He's your new mentor, and you have to keep trying. Your father's right, you know. You're out to destroy everything that is good in this country.
Dr. Goebbels is my superior. I have to do my work.
Deputy Fuhrer Hess wants to see you at National Party headquarters in Munich, and he wants to see you right now. But before you get on that train, let me remind you that Dr. Goebbels feels that it is his sacred duty to keep the Fuhrer's mind free for state decisions and not cluttered up with a lot of new faces and names to remember. And he feels that he can handle most of the people and the problems that would come to the Fuhrer's attention. Just remember that the Fuhrer has seen your sketches, and he's most enthusiastic.
He has beer.
Yes.
Your ticket.
Oh, thank you.
And your hat.
Thank you. Oh, by the way, the doctor is going to take credit for your ideas.
I don't understand.
That's all part of the doctor's ways and means of not cluttering the Fuhrer's mind with a new name and a new face to remember.
Mind.
Now you understand. I can see by your eyes that you understand.
Only the Fuhrer can decide this sort of thing.
Every bird he has a mate, every poodle has a name. The bomb in Paris, in the spring. Oh, every duck, every seed seems to get in every bomb in Paris.
This where the Chancellor of Germany lives?
Yes, second floor.
Beer? Come on. The Fuhrer's expecting you. Go in.
Put them there. Agreed.
Yes, my Führer. Speer, wait. Yes, my Führer. You're to go back to National Party headquarters now. Deputy Führer Hess will brief you there. His chief of staff is expecting you.
I'm Bormann. This way. Gov.
The Führer has decided to incorporate some of your ideas at Tempelhof this year.
That will be all.
Years ago, in Vienna, even before I knew him, the Führer wanted to study architecture. Tried to study architecture. Perhaps in his soul of souls, he still yearns to be an architect. Hmm? Did you get that feeling from him, Speer?
No.
Perhaps that is because really he is not an architect. Is he, Speer?
No.
What is he? What is he? What is Adolf Hitler, Speer?
Why, he's the Chancellor of Germany.
Führer! 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 Adolf Hitler is your Führer. He is your leader in all things at all times. Keep that clearly in mind. At no time is Adolf Hitler anything less than your Führer. You slipped through. You weren't supposed to get closer to the Führer than his adjutant. You weren't supposed to see him at all.
The deputy Führer Hess arranged it.
He's a terribly confused man. If he'd had the remotest idea that you were to be received by the Führer, I can assure you, you would have been the very smallest part of a very large delegation at the very back of the room. Train tickets. Car's waiting downstairs. Have a pleasant trip. Speer. I'm not a forgetting man.
This one.
To see you. I own the place, so I'm glad to see you. Before the place is nationalized, in the New Germany, I want to explain to you, if you're confused, what the New Germany is. This afternoon, I tried to collect my thoughts, and I was arrested for unlawful assembly. Hitler has Wagner, I have Trudy. Now, our new chancellor, Herr Hitler, as you know, ran for the presidency against President Hindenburg 2 years ago, and he lost. And immediately there were calls for a recount by President von Hindenburg. Now, there was an election in America as well. I want you to compare the two leaders. Mr. Roosevelt is the president there. Mr. Roosevelt, upon taking office, forgave all his enemies. Herr Hitler, upon taking office here, arrested all his friends. Herr Hitler Himmler has a team. Goebbels to write the speeches, Hess to transcribe speeches. Or you might say he takes dictation, but then the whole team does. Now, how did we go from the country of Schiller and Beethoven and Bismarck in a few hundred years to the country of Goebbels and Goering and Hess and Hitler? What do you make of that? Probably that Darwin was wrong.
Filthy Jew!
Well, what did you say?
I said you're a filthy Jew!
I'd like to go, please.
Don't be alarmed. We're used to this. These people come in every night. I know it's shocking, but it's true. They come in every night, and they try to stop me. But this is not the first time that they have failed in the dark.
Do you know that they were going to walk up on that stage in front of everyone and beat him up? Who knows, kill him? They can do that sort of thing, you know. Hardly anyone ever stops them. Those awful men in those brown shirts, they run this country.
Oh, that's propaganda. That's all it is. Nothing but propaganda.
They're taking our lives away from us, Albert. It isn't propaganda. Everything around us is like a dress rehearsal for a disaster.
Genuine and complete admiration for Mr. Roosevelt, the way he's taken over the office, the way he's actually become their president.
I couldn't agree more. Neither could I, my Führer.
Definitely their president.
The office and the man, one and the same.
Roosevelt is the White House. No detours, no side roads, just straight through, over the Congress, over the lobbies, over the whole Washington bureaucracy. Roosevelt simply refuses to let anyone or anything slow him down.
Gentlemen, we have a rather large agenda today.
Speer?
5 minutes.
There you are, Sheik. That's all a perfect example of the kind of waste and corruption that happens in a democracy.
No. Laziness and liberalism, not to Germans. Germans like tight public order, part of our blood, character of the nation. This place is a shambles. They gather right down there and demand a blessing of me. I'm not the Pope, Speer, but I have to do something. They come from all over the country. Can you pull out this window? Make a balcony for me?
Certainly.
here. A balcony, you know. Professor Troost's plans for the renovation. Professor Troost insists that his plans be adhered to strictly. It is not my place to say, of course, Herr Speer, but it would be most inadvisable to respond to any casual suggestion today that might be forgotten tomorrow.
You're quite right, Herr Elster. It isn't your place to say.
We do not pray to the Almighty. Lord, make us free. We wish to be active, to work, to behave.
Primo Carnera may be the heavyweight champion of the world, but he's hardly the Reich's Chancellor.
We can stand before the Lord and beseech him.
The right film, please.
Thou seest that we have become different, that the German people is no longer a people without honor, a people covered with shame, a people at war with itself. A people of little courage. No, Lord.
Yes, I'll be right with you, Speer.
The German people have become strong again. In its spirit, strong. In its will, strong. In its perseverance, strong.
Yes, let's stay at the wide shot while the crowd are cheering, responding to Sieg Heil's. But when the Führer is speaking, I want more close-ups.
And our freedom, and now with our German people and our fatherland.
Sieg Heil! Sieg Heil! Sieg Heil! Sieg Heil!
Beer? Yes, I'll be right with you. One moment, please. Where's that footage on Rome? Is it here today?
Yes, he ought to be at the end of this.
I want all this footage to emphasize the long association and great friendship that has always existed between the Führer and SA leader Ernst Röhm.
And what about Rust?
Sorry, Speer. Where is he?
He's next.
I don't want Rust on the screen longer than 30 seconds.
Henceforth, in all public schools, teachers and pupils will greet each other. Heil Hitler, thumb level with the eye. This salute is expected of every German in every walk of life, every day. There will be no exceptions. It is now the law of the land.
I'm so very glad you dropped by tonight, Speer, if for no other reason than to get me out of that projection room. Magda says I spend most of my time watching film. She says it'll ruin my eyes. Well, we're all busy these days. And I've heard that you're keeping the Führer very busy, too.
Oh, he's keeping me busy.
Well, that's his way.
The higher he aims, the more a man grows. The Führer's favorite phrase.
Oh, yes, yes.
The Führer does have a way of making a man feel indispensable, wouldn't you say?
Yes. I find him very like a woman in that respect. He can make you unhappy one moment and deliriously happy the next.
You are a very busy architect these days.
I just commented on that very thing.
Did you?
I'll bet you did. Hi, pal.
Why don't you pour our guest a drink?
That's your office. He's your guest. You pour him a drink.
I hate to admit it, but you're absolutely correct.
I try.
I suppose the Führer wants the work on the residency done as soon as possible.
Yes, he's very anxious to see it completed.
He's always in a rush, always.
Never changes.
And you want to please the Führer, don't you, Speer?
Of course. I understand the Führer's taking great personal interest in the renovations.
Yes.
He's looking over your shoulder all the time.
More or less.
Must be nerve-wracking.
He likes the details, sir.
Oh, we all know that.
We certainly do.
Doesn't that bother you?
No.
Oh.
I can understand it.
Can you?
I can understand him.
Can you indeed?
Understand him.
Really? Is that so?
Yes, I think I do understand him.
Is brandy all right for you, Speer?
Fine, sir.
It's always a mistake to understand the Führer too quickly.
Or too simply.
Or too glibly. You see, Speer, a great many people come into his ken each day. It's only natural that some should delude themselves with false hopes.
What false hopes?
Doctor.
What false hopes, Doctor?
I don't think he understands what you're saying.
Do you?
Do you understand what I'm saying? Why I sent for you?
No.
Well, Herr Professor Troost is very conscious of his professional and academic standing. Even the Führer must see him by appointment at his studio in Munich. Playing the role of surrogate architect for Troost isn't going to open up any new vistas that you might be seeing for yourself these days, Speer. Troost has been, is, and always will be, the Führer's personal architect. An inner and an outer circle revolves around the Führer. There is no way, no possible way, that anyone will make room for you in that inner circle.
No. Thank you, Doctor.
Where you can shut him up so I can get my picture.
I want to talk to you seriously. Look, my dewy friend, you slept with this Gentile girl. That's nothing to cry about.
I don't think you're being very manly.
My little friend, all we want you to do is stop crying. Blow your nose and smile for the pretty birdie. Damn it, I don't think that's asking too much. Cheer up! Be happy! We're all happy, aren't we? Let's have one more of the nice little man in the suit.
Learn. You must learn to turn your eyes away.
What is this spear? It's not regular plaster, is it?
Ground seashells. The Italians and the Greeks made a mortar from them. Very hard, very moisture resistant.
Clumsy.
I want you to have lunch with me today.
I'm afraid I'm...
Don't you worry about that. I'll take care of it.
Today. I'm famished.
Come on, sit down, sit down. Set a new place here for my colleague.
Handsome jacket, Spear.
Thank you, Doctor.
Yes, we both thank you, Doctor. We shall have to go to Munich one of these days and wear sackcloth and ashes for Professor Troost when he sees some of the changes we've made on his original plans. You know, come to think of it, I thought he was looking a bit frail. Not that he's ever been a robust man, but particularly frail, I thought.
A bit slow the last time I saw him.
And that age, you know, should take very special care of himself. Well, any age, really. We all have but this one instrument, and we must all use it as sparingly and carefully as possible. After all, now, this is interesting. We are all exactly what we eat. No more, no less. And, for instance, to me, the very idea of eating animal flesh has become so odious that I'm inclined to diet myself to fruits and vegetables for the rest of my life. Believe me, vegetarians will inherit this earth.
Oh, this is a pleasure.
Thank you.
This is the most important day of my life. Good morning to you.
My
dear. Bring honor to our village.
And a very good morning to you.
Oh.
Thank you.
My Führer.
My friend.
Good morning, my Führer.
Hitler Fever, you are the Chancellor of Germany. Your Führer and mine, who did not drag us to Ober-Salzburg to discuss with us anything he couldn't discuss at some other time and some other place. Is it 2 o'clock yet?
As a matter of fact, it is exactly 2 o'clock.
The Chancellor of Germany standing in front of the house with the dog.
Yes.
The brown tweed suit, the brown scarf with the white polka dots.
Yes.
And the velour hat with the feather.
Yes.
That's a nice touch. And the expectant look, above all.
Yes.
And now the Führer's car approaching. Bearing the bodies of two loyal secretaries, Frau Wolf and Frau Schroeder. And?
Frau Wolf, Frau Schroeder, and?
And?
I don't know.
Her name's Eva Braun, pal. She's the girlfriend.
You see, I've lost so much time. I have to work twice as fast now. I'll stay in power for 22 years, then I'll retire. But first, I have to get more power so that I don't have to bother with the cabinet. Because now they think they have a perfect right to meddle in things that are absolutely none of their business. Good morning, ladies. Good morning. Wonderful day. Wonderful day. If I had my way, I'd outlaw skiing in this country. Dangerous, freezing, crippling business. Hate it. Hate it. Hate it. Snow makes me so depressed.
By a waterfall, I'm calling you. We can share it all beneath a ceiling of blue. We'll spend a heavenly day.
waterfall, I'm calling you. We can share it all beneath our ceiling of blue. We'll spend a heavenly day here where the whispering waters play. There's a whippoorwill that's calling you. By a waterfall, he's dreaming too. There's a magic melody Mother Nature sings to me. Beside a waterfall with you.
He's very much against smoking.
Can I join you?
Oh, yes, yes, of course. And I don't know what I'm going to do when he gets really serious about eating nothing but vegetables and fruit. It's a worry. You're a college professor?
I was a college professor.
You're very young.
You're very young.
Oh, I don't feel young or old. I feel good. I'm never sick, and that's more important than anything I can think of. You're not any different. People are usually very different at close range. You're not at all.
Eva?
Albert. If we are going to be friends, I think I should tell you that I'm not just a person from nowhere. No one really is. No one exists in a vacuum. But I know it's on your mind. And I know you're wondering. I was working as a photographic assistant for Heinrich Hoffmann when I met him. He was in love with another woman at that time. She committed suicide. I have a mother, a father, and two sisters who tell me, who constantly tell me that the day I met him was the bitterest day of my life.
Well, the doctor is the smartest of the bunch, but it'll probably take him the longest to figure out what to do about you.
What should he do about me?
Nothing. You don't threaten him. You don't threaten any of them. They don't have to compete with you the way they do with each other. You're in a class all by yourself, my friend. You're an artist. Once they figure that out, if they figure it out, they'll leave you alone. All except him. Don't ever turn your back on him. He'll always be at your throat or at your feet.
They were sleeping.
Who's that?
Elspeth. How very nice to see you again.
Frau Goebbels.
May I present my family? This is Helga, and this is Hilde.
She looks... Go on, let's take them in. Mind how you go. There we go.
I can't hide from all the things that are Nazi. I can't pretend that they're happening somewhere else to someone else.
But you managed to keep this desperation from him.
Not very well, I'm afraid. Not the way a proper German housewife should.
Well, that's what you want to be, is it? A proper German housewife?
Of course. But if I speak of these things any more than I already have, then I would have to demand that he condemn them. He won't do that.
Now, listen to me, my dear. We're not enemies, you and I. We three are bound together by memory, by fear, by, well, by the simple word love. If there's anything on which I'm an authority, it is love.
You surprised me, Father.
I dare say. Ah, you smile so nicely. This love, you know, is a very serious business with the profoundest obligations. You do love him, don't you?
I love him.
And you need him?
I need him.
And he needs you?
No.
Oh, yes, he does. Though neither of you may think so. He needs you, and he needs this child that's coming, and all the children you can give him to provide the sanity which otherwise is missing. One of these days, his obsession with this gutter politician will come to an end.
But in the meantime, what are we to do?
The most difficult thing in the world is to teach yourself to live with something you hate in order to keep the thing you love. Is that wine not to your liking?
No, it's very good.
Why are you crying then?
I love you, Father.
Professor Tisdenau has been removed from the university. He might have been arrested and sent to Sachsenhausen.
Sachsenhausen?
They're not sure.
This is your father. He's your friend, Albert.
I hope Herr Hitler hasn't blinded you to that.
Yes, I know. Goodbye.
You have a friend in Sachsenhausen?
Maybe. What is it?
It's a place that has been designed to benefit those of any race, faith, or social position who have not been able to accept the fact that the Third Reich has definitely and irrefutably dawned.
At dear old Sachsenhausen, our gallant SS men instill in such persons a feeling for discipline and order, neatness and comradeship.
You look unimpressed. You're not interested in our national socialistic movement?
Frankly, I'm not.
You, eat with him? You go to the movies with him? You talk to him? He talks to you? If he drank, you drink with him? You are the nearest thing he's got to a friend. I know, I was there once myself. It's a pretty powerful position, being his pal.
Albert Speer calling from the Führer's home at Ober-Salzburg.
Yes, yes.
Is this the Reich's minister?
Yes. How can I serve you, Herr Speer?
I am calling in relation to this matter of Professor Heinrich Tessenau.
There is no doubt about the seriousness of Professor Tessenau's situation, Herr Speer.
He's been under surveillance for 6 months. Most incriminating.
Most regrettable. Misunderstanding?
No. Herr Stauffer. I assure you, Herr Speer, we have been most careful.
Be right there.
Has Professor Tessenau been dismissed from the educational chamber?
Of course. The evidence is overwhelming. And has he been removed from his seat at university?
Yes. But again, I must tell you that the evidence...
Those are definitely mistakes. Has he been sent to Sachsenhausen?
Not yet. But Herr Stauffer can answer any questions that you might have.
Are we talking at cross purposes?
I would hope not.
I'm not here to ask questions. I'm here to call these certain mistakes to your attention so they can be rectified. Professor Tessenow must be readmitted to the educational chamber and restored to his seat at the university without prejudice, without interference, without surveillance, and most of all, Herr Reichsminister, without delay.
Last October, I went to Munich to lay the cornerstone for the House of Art. Troost had designed a special silver hammer for the occasion. When I tapped the brick with it, it shattered in my hand. Right then, I knew something was going to happen. It was an evil omen. Well, now we know why the hammer broke that day. It's all very clear. Troost was destined to die.
Attend to Frau Goebbels, will you?
See that she gets home safely.
May I express my condolences, Albert? I quite understand the high regard you held for Professor Troost.
Thank you, Frau Goebbels.
I suppose you'll be taking over all of Troost's work now.
Yes. It would seem so.
Yes. It would